The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 7th canto, 9th chapter, text number 12, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded in August of 1968 in Montreal, Canada.
Tasmadaham vigata viklavai sarasya sarvatmana mahiginami jathamani sam nicho jaya guna visarga mano pravishtya puyeta jena puman anuvannitena. So the prayer is for offering prayer to the Supreme Personality of Godhead. You do not require any high qualification. It doesn't matter. You can offer your prayer from any standard of life. Not that you have to become a very learned man, very scholarly man, and you have to present your prayers in a very nicely selected words, so that poetry, rhetoric, prosody, everything is there, metaphor, nothing required. Simply you have to express your feelings. So what is that real feeling? One must be aware of his position. Then one can express his feeling. Feeling should be very sincere and automatic. And what is our position? That has been taught by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu teaches us how to pray. He says in his prayer, Nadanangana janangana sundaring kavitang ba jagadisa kamai. Jagadisa, O my Lord of the universe. Jagat Isa. Jagat means universe. And Isha means Lord. So, it does not matter whether you are Hindu, or Muslim, or Christian, or anyone, it does not matter. But you must know that there is a supreme controller of this universe. How can you deny it? Therefore this word has been used very nicely by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Jagadisha. Jaya Jagadisha Hare. It is universal. Now, if you think that my father is Jagadisha, that is your conviction, but Jagadisha is me, meaning the Supreme. No controller there. Everyone is controlled. As soon as you see that somebody is controlled, he cannot be the Supreme. So to find out the Jagadisha, the Brahma Sanghita gives us information who is Jagadisha. And who is the Jagadisha, the Supreme? The Brahma says, Ishara Parama Krishna. Jagadisha, Isha, the same word, Ishara. Isha means controller. So every one of us is controller to some extent. If somebody has nothing to control, he keeps one cat or dog to control. My dear cat, please come here. He's thinking I'm controller. And sometimes we find the dog controls the master. Actually, nobody is controller. everyone is controlled. But we forget the situation. This is called Maya. Therefore we refuse to accept any controller of this universe. Because as soon as we accept some controller, then we'll have to account for our sinful activities. As soon as there is a government, then we shall be responsible for our unlawful activities. But our position is that we want to continue our sinful activities. As such, it is very good to deny any controller. That is the basic principle of godlessness. Why these rascals, they deny there is no God, God is dead? Because they want to continue their rascaldom without any restriction. That is the basic principle, they deny. But do you mean to say that denying the God will die or God will, there will be no God? No. There is a nice Bengali proverb, Shokuni shape goru morena. Shokuni means the vulture. The vulture wants a dead carcass of animal, a cow especially. So for days together they do not get it. So it is cursing some cow, you die. So does it mean that by its cursing the cow will die? Similarly, these vultures, Shokuni, they want to see God is dead. At least they take pleasure, oh now God is dead. I can do anything nonsense I like. This is going on. Shokuni is cursing, the vulture is cursing the cow. So, this sort of knowledge will not do. One must know that there is a controller. That is the beginning of knowledge. Why should you deny? In every field of activities we find some controller. How can I deny that there is no controller of this creation? There is. Therefore Chaitanya Mahaprabhu particularly uses this word. He is not manufacturing that word. This Jagadisha, this word is there in the Vedic language. In many verses, Jaya Jagadisha Hare. Kesavadhita Buddha Sarira Jaya Jagadisha Hare. The Jagannath, Jagadisha, the same word. Jagannath, Jagannath. Jagat Isha, Jagadisha. So, and who is that Jagadisha? That is being defined by Brahma, the first living creature of this universe, in the Brahma Sanghita. Ishara Parama Krishna. The Supreme Lord. Parama means supreme. Parama means the best, the supreme, the superior. Just like we manufacture, we prepare sometimes paramanna. Anna, anna means foodstuff. And paramanna means that sweet rice. It is called paramanna. Amongst all sorts of rice preparation, that sweet rice preparation is considered to be the best. So param is used when it is the best or the supermost. So Ishara, controller. There are many controllers. Might is right. But nobody is supreme controller. That is not possible. Nobody. Everyone is trying to become the supreme controller. But that is not being possible. by individual effort, by national effort, by communal effort. Anyway, every community, every nation, every individual person is trying to be the supreme. Therefore, there is competition. Everyone is trying to be the supreme. But that is not possible. This world, this creation is so mad that nobody is supreme. Any position you place yourself, you will find somebody inferior to you and somebody superior to you. Nobody can say that I am superior or I am inferior. If you think that you are inferior, you will find somebody immediately less inferior than you. And if you think you are superior, you will find immediately somebody is more superior than you. So this is our position. And what is God's position? That is described in the Vedic literature, in Bhagavad Gita, asamartha. Asamartha means nobody is superior, nobody is equal. Two things. If you find somebody who has no competitor, equal, and who has no superior, then he is God. The definition of God can be given in two words. One who has no superior and has no equal. Asamartha. This is the Vedic version. In the Upanishad, it is said, Natasya sama adhikasya drishyate. Nobody is found equal to him or greater than him. Natasya sama adhikasya drishyate. Parasya sakti vividaiva sriyate. And his energies are manifested in so many ways. Natasya karjam karanancha vidyate. And he has nothing to do. Everyone take any important man, take your president, just like the president of United States of America, he is considered to be the supreme man in the States. But as soon as there was some disturbance in Central Europe, immediately he had to call meetings of his cabinet and to consider how to deal with the situation. So he has to do something, always. If he does not do anything, then he is Navat, the supreme man. But in the Vedic literature we find, Natasya karjam karanancha vidyat. He has nothing to do. That is superior. If he has to do something, then he is not superior, supreme. He cannot. He is acting. He will be interested to know that one European gentleman, he went to Calcutta and he visited several temples in Calcutta. And he visited our temple also. Our temple is Radha Krishna. This is the picture, Radha Krishna. So he went to the temple of Goddess Kali. He saw the Goddess Kali's very ferocious feature, and he has got one, what is called, chopper in her hand, and she is chopping the heads of the demons, and she has the garlands of the heads of the demons, and engaged in fighting. So, he's supposed to be intelligent man. He said that I find in this temple there is God. Why you conclude like that? That in every temple I saw that a god deity is doing something. But here I see the god is enjoying. He has nothing to do. Very nice conclusion. This is Vedic conclusion. Why? If he's God, now this nonsense, they're becoming God by meditation. Does it mean by meditation one can become God? Do you think a dog meditates and becomes God? This is all nonsense. God is God, all is God. Just like Krishna. He is God in the lap of his mother. The putana, the demonic woman came to poison the child. She came in a very beautiful girl's dress and asked Yashoda, "Oh, Yashoda, you have got very nice baby. Will you kindly give me? I can offer my breast." Yashoda was very simple, village woman. "Oh yes, you can take my child." But her intention was, she smeared poison on her breast, that as soon as Krishna will suck, then the child will die. So this is the demonic spirit. They want to kill Krishna always, that's all. God is dead. They want to see how Krishna can be killed, how Krishna is dead. That is their business. There is no God, or God is impersonal, or God is dead, or so many things. That means they want to see there is no God. Or to kill God, always thinking, as soon as Krishna will take his birth, I'll take the baby and kill. But God is always God. The putana Rakshasi took the child and allowed to suck her breast, and God is so kind, he sucked the breast and sucked her life. Everything finished. And she appeared, a great giant-like demon. You know the story, putana. So this God, this child God, in the lap of his mother, is God. He did not become God by meditation, by penance, or by austerity, or by following rules and regulations. Why? He is substantially God. The God's manifestation is always there. That is God. Natasya karyam karanam cha vidyate. He has nothing to do. If anyone has to do something to become God, he is a dog. He is not God. Immediately understand. If somebody advertises that by meditation he has become God, by worshipping such and such deity he has become God, immediately take that he is dog. Because the Vedic definition says, natasya karyam karanam cha vidyate. Why God has to do something to become God? If you manufacture something, gold, that is chemical gold, that is not gold. Gold is natural. Similarly, God is natural. And the womb of his mother, he is God. In the lap of his mother, he is God. While he is playing with his boyfriends, as cowherds walk, he is God. While he is dancing with his girlfriends, he is God. While he is fighting in Kurukshetra, he is God. While he is marrying, he is God. While he is speaking, he is God. That is God. To understand God, there is no difficulty. If you try to understand Krishna, then God is there. Therefore, Brahma recommends Ishara Parama Krishna. The Supreme God, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, is Krishna. And Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita himself that Matta Paratara Nannadasti Kinchi Dhananjaya. My dear Arjuna, Dhananjaya, there is no better object than me. Kinchidas, nothing. Many places. Aham sarvasya prabhava. I am the origin. I am the fountain head of everything. Everything means he is the fountain head of Lord Shiva, he is Lord fountain is the origin of Vishnu, he is origin of Brahma, he is origin of Lord Shiva, and what to speak of other demigods, and what to speak of other living creatures. Mavai mamsa jiva bhuta, all these living creatures, they are all my parts and parcels. Therefore, he is the origin. And the Brahma Sanghita, the Brahma in his Sanghita, Sanghita means Vedic literature. So, he explains that you are finding out God, here is God. Everywhere he'll find. But the rascal demons are so obstinate that although Krishna is confirmed, the Supreme God, by Brahma, by Shiva, by Vyasa, Narada, Devala, and many, many devotees, Bhishma, there are 12 standard acharyas. Sambhu, Narada, Sambhu. Sambhu means Brahma, Narada, Narada Muni, and Sambhu means Lord Shiva, Kapila, Vyasa, Kumara. Everyone has accepted. And in the recent years, Lord Chaitanya, he says, and the Bhagavad says, Krishna Stu Bhagavan Sam. Bhagavan gives least of all incarnations of God. And at the last, he concludes that in this list, they name Krishna. He is the Supreme Personality. Krishna Stu Bhagavan Sam. And all other manifestations, they are incarnation. Ite cha angsa kala. All these different names of God, they are either parts or part of the parts. The part of parts is called kala and part is called amsa. We are also amsa, but we are very fragmental amsa. We are not as big as Vishnu. We are very fragmented. We are also Hansa. So Hansa, Kala. So all others, they are either Hansa or Kala, but Krishna, Krishnastu, tu means but. Krishnastu Bhagavan Sam. He is the Supreme Personality of God. So our prayer should be to the Supreme Personality of God. Therefore we pray, Govindam Adipurusham Tamaham Bhajami. We worship the Supreme Personality of Godhead, the original person. We are all person, just like your father is person, therefore you are person, your son is person. Similarly, your father is his person, his father person, his father person, go to Brahma, he is also person, his father Vishnu is person, his father everywhere, Krishna, the Supreme Person. A God cannot be without being person. He must be personal. With impersonal understanding of God, Nirakarvadi, that Nirakar, of course, in the Vedic language, when you speak Nirakar, ni means negative, and akar means form. So negative form means not that he has no form, but he has no form like you and me. That is negative. Form means just like we have got form. Then what is the value of this form? This form will be changed after a few years. As soon as I give us this body, this form is changed, just like we change our dress. Therefore, he hasn't got a form like this to be changed. Therefore, it's sometimes called Nirakar. Akar is there, and that is also explained in the Brahma Samhita, that Ishara Parama Krishna. Oh, Krishna has got a form, sir. How he said that he is the Supreme, Brahma is the Supreme. No, he has form, certainly. Satchidananda Vigraha. His form is not like you and me. Satchit Ananda. His form is eternal, full of bliss and full of knowledge. Satchidananda Vigraha. Ishara Parama Krishna Satchidananda Vigraha Anadi. He has no source. He has no source. He is original. He is the source of everything. Anadi, Radhi. And he is the original Govinda. Govinda means he gives pleasure. How do you perceive pleasure? Through your senses. So therefore go means senses. And Inda means pleasure. So if you serve Krishna in your purified senses, then you really become happy. Therefore his name is Govinda. Ishara Parama Krishna Satchidananda Vigraha Anadi Radhi Govinda Sarvakarana Karanam. The cause of all causes. So he is therefore Jagadisha. Yet Prahlad Maharaj is trying to offer his prayers to the Supreme Personality of God. Isharasa Mahi Gnami. Mahi. Mahi means glories. He is glorious activities. Don't you think his activities are glorious? He is modern scientist, has manufactured one, what is called Sputnik, and we are advertising in the paper. Oh, so nice Sputnik, it is flying in the air and it is going. And the Supreme Personality has created not only a child Sputnik, but millions and trillions of planets, they are flying in the air. So, is not it glorious? But the rascals will say, Jagat Mitha, this world is false. Why it is false? There are so much brain in manufacturing this world, and is it false? Suppose if you decorate this temple and invite some friend, if he says, this is all false, is it not decrying or insulting you? You decorate this temple so nicely, you prepare very nice foodstuff, and he says, this is all false. Why? That means he has to appreciation. He is prosaic, he is dull, he is rascal. So therefore, devotees, they appreciate, oh God, oh Krishna, how nice you are. How nicely you have manufactured these trees, these flowers, the sky, the planets, the sun, the moon. And he becomes overwhelmed with joy. Oh my God, he's so great. And the rascal says, it's false. You see, how much rascal then? False. Is it false? If you want to construct one building, you have to work hard your whole life. And if I say it is false, how much insulted you are. So they do not know, they have no idea what is God. Yes. So here Prahlad Maharaj says, Ishvarasa mahi gnani, I shall glorify the Lord. You are a child, sir. You are 5 years old, how you can glorify? Jatha manisa. It doesn't matter, I am child. Whatever I have got, I shall express my feelings. Oh God, oh Lord, you are so great. That's all right. How you can describe God or understand His glory? That is not possible. He's unlimited. But whatever limitation you have got, if you express feelingly, my God, my Lord, that will be accepted. That will be accepted. The Chaitanya Mahaprabhu therefore teaches us how to pray. This prayer is na dhanang na janang na sundaring kavitang bhajagadisa kamai. Everyone is praying to God with some interest. That is also good. If you go and pray to God, give me some money or give me some relief, give me a nice house, nice wife, nice food stuff, that is also good. But not so good as one is praying to God that I don't want any money, I don't want any number of followers, I don't want any good wife, nice beautiful wife. Then what do you want? I want to serve you. That's it. Here is your prayer. That is the best prayer. You are so good, you are so nice, you are so great that I want to be engaged in service. I am serving these rascals, they are not satisfied, I am not satisfied. Now I have come to you, please engage me in your service. That is the last word of prayer. Thank you.
You mean to say nothing? God is nothing?
No. I mean, why does he say my God? Why my God?
Then what shall he say?
I don't understand him. How can he say? If you understand nothing belongs to you, then how can you say mine? Anything mine?
Anything mine?
How can you say that God is mine?
No. What is your idea? He should be addressed. He should not say my Lord. He's Lord of everyone. Therefore, everyone can say, my Lord. That does not mean if somebody says, my Lord, he becomes monopolized. It does not mean. You are speaking on the platform of monopolizing, my. The God is never monopolized. He's everyone. So everyone has the right to say, my God. My Lord. It does not mean, generally, in the material sense, when I say, this is my spectacle, it does not belong to you. Is it not? So this my is not that my. When I say my God, that does not mean he is not your God. That is the difference. In the material sense, when I say it is my wife, then it is not any other's wife. But God is not like that. If I say my God, so you can say my God, he can say my God, everyone can say my God. This is spiritual mind, absolute mind. But try to understand this way, that in the material sense, when I say something my, that is different from when I say my God. That is different. That is not exactly as we think in the material way, my thing, my God, my home, my wife, my wealth, my bank. It is not like that. But the relationship, just like I say my hand, so how can I express? Just like Krishna says, mamaivansa, mama means mine. All these living creatures, they are my part and parcel. So why the living creatures shall not say, my God? Do you follow? Krishna says, you are mine. Why shall you not say, Krishna, you are mine? Your husband says, you are mine. Why shall you not say, you are mine? But don't take it in the material sense. In material sense, as soon as I say, this mine, it is nobody else. It is my property. Law of identity or something like that. So Krishna is not like that. So you can say, Krishna, my, there is no I. Rather, if anyone wants to possess something as he is, that possession should be Krishna. That is the ultimate conception of mind. That is the perfection of the word mind. So it is quite nice, quite fit to Teshute Mai in the Bhagavad Gita. He is mine and I am his. Krishna says. So this is not wrong. And what is your idea? That because everything belongs to Krishna, therefore I shall not say mine, that's your idea? Yes. Yes. He's mine, he's your, everyone. That's all. That's all. Yes. What is that? I do not follow. What is Janardhan?
She's saying she falls so far away from you when you are not here.
That you should not think. The words, there are two conceptions, the physical conception and the vibration conception. The physical conception is temporary. The vibration conception is eternal. Just like we are enjoying or we are relishing the vibration of Krishna's teachings. So by vibration he is present. As soon as we chant Hare Krishna or chant Bhagavad Gita or Bhagavat, so he is present immediately by his vibration. He is absolute. Therefore, vibration is more important than physical presence. When you feel separation from your spiritual master, you just try to remember his words of instruction, he will not feel separation. He will feel that he is with you. So we should associate by the vibration, not by the physical presence. That is real association. Sadhyadana vritti, by sound, just like we are touching Krishna immediately by sound vibration. So we should give more stress on the sound vibration, either of Krishna or of the spiritual master, then we'll feel happy and no separation. When Krishna departed from this world, at that time Arjuna was overwhelmed with sorrow, and he began to remember the instruction of Bhagavad Gita. He'll find in the Srimad Bhagavatam, then he was pacified. Immediately began to remember the teachings which was taught to him in the battlefield of Kurukshetra, and he was pacified. He was his constant friend. So when Krishna went to his abode, he was feeling overwhelmed, but he began to remember his teaching. So whenever we shall feel separation, the best thing is to remember the teachings, then it will be very nice. Is that clear? Yes. So you can chant Hare Krishna, Janardhan, you can play Vedanga, yes.